In this session, we will control the switch here and the LED we used last time. But as I mentioned, we will control it using interrupts. So, when this button is recognized as pressed, the LED will turn on or off, toggling each time it is pressed. We will control the switch using interrupts in this way. I have opened the code from last time, and I will erase it and try again. From the machine module, we import the pin class, which is essential for controlling the input and output pins on the microcontroller. From the time module, we import the sleep function, which allows us to introduce delays in our program. The LED, which stands for light emitting diode, is connected to pin number 25 on the microcontroller. This setup is similar to what we did the last time we configured this system. The key, which functions as a button or switch, is connected to pin number 14, and it is configured as an input pin. Please ensure that you set the pin configuration correctly to avoid any potential issues that could arise from incorrect setting. We will also be using a global variable in our program, which is a variable that can be accessed from anywhere within the program. We will initialize this variable by setting its state to 0, which is its default starting value. For now, let's proceed with this initial setup to ensure everything is in place. Just in case you get confused or need a reminder, for the key, we will set up an interrupt. This interrupt will be configured with the IRQ method and will trigger on a falling edge. This means that when the input value on the key changes from a high state to a low state, it will automatically call the function that we define here. Now, we will define a function called onHolding, and within this function, we will declare that we will be using the global variable by using the global keyword. This declaration is crucial because it allows the function to modify the global variable. Finally, we will set the sleep duration to 0.01 seconds, which is a very short delay to ensure that our program runs smoothly and efficiently. This short delay is important because it helps to prevent the program from running too quickly and potentially missing important input signal. After the delay, if not K value, key and K are essentially the same. This is because when the interrupt triggers, which is an event that temporarily halts the current operations to execute a specific task, and this function is called, the value that comes here corresponds to the instance of this key. As I mentioned last time, it needs to be true, but since it is the opposite, it should be false. Therefore, since it is pull-up, which means a resistor is used to ensure that a wire is pulled to a high logical level in the absence of an input signal, just like we did last time, it will be high. So, if it works this way, that is toggling, right? Toggling refers to the action of switching between two states, such as on and off, or high and low, high. We are reversing it using the last state. So let's check it carefully like this. It's currently functioning as intended. And when I precisely press the button once, it activates the LED light. And when I press the button again, it deactivates the LED light. This operation is happening exactly as designed, just like we saw in the code. The function executes precisely at the exact moment it accurately recognizes the button as pressed, transitioning from high to low. When that function runs, we set the state variable accordingly, which alternates seamlessly between 0 and 1, resulting in the LED turning on and off like this. In this session, we controlled the LED and switch of the Raspberry Pi using MicroPython, specifically controlling the switch with interrupts. I will see you next time with another topic.